So my name is Céline Caillé, and I'm based in Lamru in Laos, in Vientiane, a little country in Southeast Asia. My main area of research is the quality of medicines. So we work on trying to understand what are the problems on substandard and falsified medicines. Substandard medicines are medicines that are manufactured by the authorized manufacturer, but there has been an error or mistake during the manufacturing process, and so these medicines are poor quality. Whereas falsified medicines are criminal activities, so they come from criminals who manufacture medicines to make profit. They most of the time contain no active ingredient or a wrong active ingredient that can be toxic. The issue of poor quality medicine is not very well understood. The estimate so far says that from the World Health Organization that 10% of medicines are poor quality medicines in low and middle income countries, which are the most affected areas. But we also know that the high income countries like Europe or in the Americas are not spared by the problem. There have been cases of fake medicines from the internet, fake cancer medicines, who managed to infiltrate the pharmaceutical supply chain in Europe. There are different ways to improve medicine quality. There are actually many that we could think of. One of the main ones for low and middle income countries is to enforce regulatory authorities. We call them medicines regulatory authorities. They are the one who control and regulates the pharmaceutical supply chain. Unfortunately, in these poor resource countries, they don't have a lot of actually resource to monitor the quality and prevent them to reach patients. So that's one of the key aspects. Engaging with Ministry of Health as well, and also international organizations who supply medicine in many countries. I think it's a global issue, not only of medicine quality, but of the access of medicines as well. I think we should more talk about the access to quality medicines now. And there is another aspect that I believe is very important, is raising awareness, both in low and middle income countries, but also in high income countries, to prevent from unsafe behaviors that can lead to taking poor quality medicines, unfortunately. So in our group, the most important line of research, we're trying to understand the issues. It's been quite a neglected field of research. We don't really understand what are the problems, where they are. So we've been working on trying to understand that and visualize what and where the problems are. We've been also working on testing new devices that can enforce medicines regulators, medicine inspectors, when especially in low and middle income countries. Medicine inspectors go to the pharmacy, they check the quality of medicines, but currently they use only their eyes to see if a medicine is good quality or not. So we are working on providing screening technologies so that the medicine inspectors, also police officers, custom officers can use to identify poor quality medicines and remove them from the market. The reason why our research matters is that for any diseases, you need to understand the issues to better inform policy and to engage with stakeholders. So that's one of the reasons why our research matters. By understanding the issues, we can really engage with the important people to take action against poor quality medicines. The use of screening technology, we hope, will enforce inspectors of the quality of medicines, and so that we have a early signal of an issue in a country of the quality of, for example, a falsified medicine in a rural area in Nigeria. And then we can take timely action against that, remove the medicine from the market, and prevent patients to reach them. So we'll save life by having these devices. So translational medicine is key in research, right? Our work on medicine quality will help to understand better the impact of poor quality medicines on antimicrobial resistance, which is a big concern at the moment. So by trying to understand the issue, we provide data for models, statistical models, so mathematical models, that can help to understand better the antimicrobial resistance. If we understand better antimicrobial resistance issues, then we can do something about it. That's one thing. The second work we are doing about screening technologies to identify poor quality medicines will also lead to recommendations on how to best deploy these devices in specific contexts, in low and middle income countries in particular. So that will inform policymakers on how best to deploy these screening technologies in their specific context.